topic, issue of shares, HA premium for future of shares and reissue of shares. What do you mean by issue of shares, HA premium? Issuing the shares for more than the face value. When the shares are issued for more than the face value, then it is called issue of shares at a premium. When the shares are issued at a premium, how to forfeit them and how to reissue those shares and what are the accounting treatment, that will be taught in this class. Please write down the problem. Arushi Company Limited issued 10,000 equity shares of rupees 10 each. Of rupees 10 each. 10,000 equity shares of rupees 10 each at a premium of rupees 2 per share. At a premium of rupees 2 per share. The amount was payable as follows. That is rupees 3 on application. Rupees 3 on application. Rupees 5 on allotment. 5 on allotment. Including premium. Rupees 5 on allotment. Including premium. So what is the premium amount? Premium is rupees 2. Rupees 4 on first and final call. Rupees 4 on first and final call. All the shares were fully subscribed and the money was duly received except the first and final call on 1000 shares. On 1000 shares. Except the first and final call on 1000 shares. The directors of the company decided to forfeit these shares and reissued them at rupees 8 per share. At rupees 8 per share. Pass necessary journal entries to record above transactions. So, in the book of the company, we have to record the above transactions. Here, first we have to draw the lines for journal entries. Now, in the book of Arushi Company Limited, we have to make the journal entries. So first journal entry for receiving the application money. How many shares are issued to the public? That is 10,000 equity shares of rupees 10 each. But at the time of application, how much amount to be paid? That is rupees 3 on each application. So what is the amount the company should receive now? 10,000 into 3. 3 is application. So what is the journal entry for recording the application money now? While receiving the application money, that should be entered in the book of the company. That is bank account debtor. Bank account debtor. Bank account debtor calculate the money now. That is, the number of shares issued are 10,000. 10,000 into each application money, that is rupees 3. So what is the amount? That is 30,000. So why bank is debited in this entry? Because bank is the receiver of the benefit. When the check is, when the payment is made in the form of check, the bank will be the receiver of the benefit, and the equity share application represents the applicants, and applicants are the givers of the benefit. For that reason, their account will be credited. So what is the narration we have right now? For this, narration means the brief explanation about the journal entry being application money received on 10,000 equity shares. Next, the application money is the part of share capital. So the application money has to be transferred to share capital account. What is the entry for transferring the money now? That is equity share application account debtor. Equity share capital account. So what is the amount received from the applicants? That is 30,000. That 30,000 will be transferred to equity share capital account. That is 30,000. Why it is transferred to equity share capital account? Because application money or allotment money or first and final call money, whichever the money, it is the part of share capital. Whenever the company receives such amount, that will be transferred to the share capital account. So equity share application account entered to equity share capital account. The 30,000, the entire amount will be transferred, and the narration will be equity share application money transferred to share capital account. So after some days, the company will start the allotment of shares. When the company starts allotment of shares, when the company sends the due notice to the applicants about the allotment, and when the letter is sent to them, they are supposed to pay the allotment money. And the allotment money, in this problem, the allotment money is collected along with the premium. When the money is collected along with the premium, the premium amount also should be recorded in the third entry. The premium amount can be collected at the time of allotment or at the time of call. In this question now, the premium amount is collected at the time of allotment. So rupees 5 including premium. Including premium means the premium amount also collected along with allotment. So when the due notice is sent to the shareholders, they have to make the entry in the books of the company. That is equity share allotment account debtor. Equity share allotment account debtor to equity share capital account. Equity share capital account to securities premium account. To securities premium account. capital, that is 10,000 into 3. That is 10,000 into 3. That is 30,000 to equity share capital account and 20,000 to equity share premium account. So that is securities premium account. Being allotment money due along with the premium on 10,000 equity shares. So after some days, when the shareholders are paying the money, that means when the company receives allotment money, they have to make one more entry. That entry is bank account debtor, bank account debtor to equity share allotment account, bank account debtor to equity share allotment account. That is, what is the total amount to be received by the company? That is 3 plus 2. So, totally 50,000. Along with premium, what will the amount collected? That will be transferred to equity share allotment account. That is 50,000. So, what is the narration you are going to give? That is, allotment money received on 10,000 equity shares along with the premium. So after some days, the first and final call money will be due. When the first and final call money is due, they have to pass one more entry for due amount, that is equity share first and final call account debtor, first and final call account debtor to call account debtor to equity share capital account. Equity share capital account. Now, what is the first and final call amount? That is rupees 4 on first and final call. So, rupees 4 on first and final call means 10,000 into 4, that is 40,000. 10,000 into 4, that is 40,000. Why equity share first and final call is debited? Because they are supposed to pay the money due amount. So they will be treated as debtors to the business till they pay the amount. So their account is debited and equity share capital is credited because it is the liability of the business. So always the liability will show the credit balance. So next, the narration has to be written. What is the narration we have to write? That is, being the first and final call money due on 10,000 equity shares. So next, while receiving the first and final call money, one more transaction has to be recorded, one more entry has to be made, that is bank account debtor to equity share first and final call account. Equity share first and final call account. That is, the same amount is not received in this question. The first and final call received except 1,000 shares. So, how many shares are issued to the public? Totally 10,000. 10,000 minus 1,000, because 1,000 shares first and final call is not received, means on how many shares they have received the first and final call? That is on 9,000 shares. So, 9,000 into first and final call money, that is rupees 4. So, what is the amount received by the company? That is 36,000. That is 36,000 on first and the final call. So the narration we are going to write is, being the first and final call money received on 9,000 equity shares. So directors decided to forfeit these shares. So which of the shares to be forfeited now? The 1,000 shares on which the first and final call money is not received. So on how many shares first and final call is not received? On So the directors wanted to forfeit the shares. Forfeiting the shares means cancelling the shares. So when the shares are cancelled, that much share capital will be reduced in the company. Share capital, always it will show the credit balance. To reduce the share capital account will be debited with the amount, that is 1000 into face value. Face value is rupees 10. So here the debit account is equity share capital account debtor. Equity share capital account debtor, that is 1000 shares into rupees 10. So the total amount reduced in the share capital is 10,000. Total amount reduced in the share capital is rupees 10,000. That is 1000 shares are forfeited with the face value. Face value of each share is rupees 10. And two accounts are credited in this entry. That is two forfeited shares account. Two forfeited shares account. Forfeited shares account to first and final call account. First and final call account. Forfeited shares account to first and final call account. So share capital 1000 into 10, and out of 10 rupee, what is the first and final call money? First and final call is rupees 4. That will be transferred to first and final call. That is 1000 into rupees 4. That is 4000. And what is the amount received from the first shareholder? Out of 10 rupee, 4 rupee is not received, means the amount received from the first shareholder, that will be transferred to forfeited shares account. So the forfeited shares amount will be 1000 into 6, that is 6000. That is 6000. Understood? No? So the amount received from the first shareholder, not including the premium, without including the premium, that is now 3 application money out of 5, 2 rupees premium means share capital will be 3. So 3 plus 3, that is 6. 6 is transferred to forfeited shares account, to first and final call account. Being 1000 forfeited shares are 1000 shares are forfeited for the non-payment of first and final call. For the non-payment of first and final call, 1000 shares are forfeited by the company. Again, directors decided to reissue the forfeited shares at rupees 8 per share. 10 rupees shares are issued at rupees 8 means. Now one more entry, that is bank account debtor. Bank account is debited with the reissue price. So reissue price is 8. That is 1000 into 8. That is 8000. So bank will receive how much amount? 8000. And when the 10 rupees shares are issued at rupees 8, so what is the discount given by the company? That is rupees 2. And that 2 rupee will be transferred to forfeited shares account. So forfeited shares account, that is 1000 into 2. From where you have 2 rupee, that is 10 rupee face value, reissue price is 8 means 10 minus 8, that is 2, that is rupees 1000 into 2, that is 2000. Again, this account also will be debited to equity share capital account. To equity share capital account. Now, equity share capital account is 1000 into 8 plus 2, that is 1000 into 10, that is 10,000. That is 10,000. So, being 1000 forfeited shares are reissued at rupees 8 per share. So last journal entry, for transferring the profit on forfeited share, we have to make one entry. From the first shareholder, what is the amount received? That is 6 is 2000 and balance of 4000 is the profit to the company, and that will be transferred to the capital reserve. Now for transferring the profit to capital reserve, one more entry, the last entry has to be passed, that is forfeited shares account debtor. Forfeited shares account debtor. Account debtor to capital reserve account. Capital reserve account. Forfeited shares account debtor to capital reserve account. That is now 6000 the amount received from the first shareholder. From that 6000 we have to deduct the discount, that is 2000 while reaching the shares 6000 minus 2000, so that is 4000. 4000 is the profit to the company, and that 4000 will be transferred to the capital reserve. And what is the last entry? That is for transferring the profit, forfeited shares account to capital reserve account, that is 6000 minus discount, that is 4000. So understood the problem? Okay, thank you for watching this video.